Okay, so we are going to play with the app designer. So just to start, and we're going to make a pretty straightforward thingy. So we're going to start with a blank app, and I'm just going to call it, I'm going to go ahead and save it as trig slider. I don't really know why, but basically what I want to do is I want to plot the sine function and then use like a knobby kind of a thing to adjust the period of the function. It'd be like a little learning exercise or something. So, come on, you can let me pull this out anymore. Yeah, okay. So we have this component library, so we are going to definitely want some axes to plot our stuff, and then we are going to get a knob. So you can, these knobs all do different kinds of things. I'm gonna do, so I don't want a discrete knob that only has specific answers. Like, I wanna be able to kind of have, you know, fractions of some value to adjust the period of the function. So there we go. Okay, so now I don't think I'm going to need anything else over here ever again, so I can throw that back over there. Okay, so essentially what we're going to do is we're going to use this knob down here to change the period of the, to change the period of the sine function. So I'm going to change it to period, and I can double click this and call this, maybe I can double click it if it lets me. Doops, doops, doops. No? Okay, well, I can just come over here and type it. So title, I'll call that y equals sine of x for the moment. Or maybe I'll just, because it's not going to be that instantly. Sine function. It doesn't really matter what we call these things. I'm going to delete all this stuff. So just to get started, let's just kind of preload it with an existing sine function. So to make that happen, you're going to go over here where it says trig slider, like or whatever you called it, and then you're going to create a startup function. So basically, you're going to say, this is what I wanted to do right when it starts the program, the app. So I just want a nice little sine function to get started, a boring one. So we'll call that whatever you want to say. We'll go negative, I don't know. 3 pi to pi, we'll do lin space so that we get a lot of points. We'll do lin space, negative 3 pi to 3 pi, we want 10,000 points, which is great. And then for y, we'll just do the sine of x. And now to plot, if you start to type plot and you open it up, notice what it's trying to get you to look at. So the first thing, when you're in the MATLAB app designer, the first thing now that you put in for the plot, AX doesn't stand for the X variable of the plottingness. AX stands for axes. You see how it says target axes. Now it's optional, but we need to tell it what to do. Now our app axes is still called app.uiaxes, which is for user interface. So app.ui, and I can just hit tab, it'll autofill. And I want it to run from X to Y. And I think this will work. Let's try it. Somewhere I can click run. That'll save it for me. There, I've got a sine function. Perfect. Okay, wonderful. And this knob does this, and nothing happens because I didn't ask it to do anything. So that's fine. Okay. Now, I think if you open this, yeah, you can see what's going on here, but I've got this closed just for y'all can be able to see more stuff. So when I come over here now, what I guess I could do is this over here. Now I'm just being unnecessarily complicated. So let's say that we want the period of the sine function to go from 0 to, say, 4 pi. Okay, so we want to be able to change this knob to go from 0 to 4 pi. So it's going to start out at a value of whatever we tell it to. Let's say that we want it to start out at a value of 2 pi, because that's the standard period for a sine function. So the limits are going to technically go from 0 to 4 pi. However, I don't actually want it to go all the way down to 0 because you can't have a period of 0. So I'm going to be really sneaky and I'm going to put an epsilon here. And that will keep it from going all the way to 0. Now it's got a dumb label, but that's okay. We're going to fix that in a second. So for the major tick marks, it's not really helpful to have tick marks like this because everything should be in terms of pi. So I'm going to just delete all this. And I'm going to say my major tick marks go from 0, skipping by pi, up to 4 pi. And if I hit tab, it automatically pops this up. Okay? So if you click this little button here, you can see how it's labeled. And if you want to come in, so this is the actual value, and this over here is the label. So I can go like pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. There's probably a way to make it pretty so it's not just the word pi, but the pi symbol. 4 pi, and there we go. So here's the period of the function. Obviously, I'll run this, and it's not going to do anything with it because I didn't tell it to do anything with it. Meow, meow, meow. Okay, let's make some other things pretty. Also, let's take a look at this for a second. I just noticed something. So this is showing us going from negative 1 to 1, which is fine, because if I change the period, that's not going to change. But it's going from, whatever, negative 10 to 10. Let's make that clear, because I really think that's negative 3 pi to 3 pi, right? That's what we did? Yeah, 3 pi to 3 pi. So let's fix these axes as well. So if I click on over here, you can come down here and it'll say x tick marks. You can kind of throw that in there. You can do the same thing where you go negative 3 pi to skipping by pi's up to 3 pi. And then it goes away because it's dumb, but I think it'll show up when we do this here. There we go. Okay. So by default, it's not going to fix it until we get there. I think there's a way to actually play with it here if I'm not too crazy. Oh, there we go. So we can change the x limit. So right now we can't see it because it's defaulting from 0 to 1. And we really want it to go from negative 3 pi to 3 pi. Now notice up on the tick mark thingy, I made it go like 3 or negative 3 pi, skip by pi's and go to 3 pi, because that's where I was telling it where I want every tick mark to go. I want every tick mark to start at negative 3, skip by pi's up to positive 3 pi. So that. But now what I'm telling it is in this particular one, I'm just going from negative 3 pi to positive 3 pi. Those are my limits. And my limit on the y-axis goes from negative 1 to 1. See, it automatically updated that here, so that's kind of nice. I might have done the other one and I just got impatient. So let's try this again. Alrighty. Now it still doesn't do anything, but that's okay because we're getting close. I also don't really like the x tick labels, so I can change those as well. So I can go negative 3 pi, why is it not letting me do this very conveniently, 2 pi, negative pi. For some reason I have to hit enter and then up, there's probably like 2 pi and 3 pi. Okay. And see, it fixes that, and it's really pretty. You can probably put in some grid lines if you want it to look a little different. X grid, Y grid, grid color, line style, grid alpha. I don't know what any of that means, but you know, you can just have some fun with it. So, you know, you can kind of tell something interesting is going on there. Okay, so now what we want is we want something to actually happen and change whenever we change this value. So if you haven't already, I mean, every time you hit run, I think it saves it for you. But just in case, give yourself a nice little clicky on the save button. Now, if you right-click this, it'll say callbacks. So we want to have a value. So there's two options. There's value changed, and there's value changing. And I think that we want it to do this every time we are changing the value. Let's see. We'll try it, and then if it's the wrong one, we'll just flip it. Okay, so basically every time it's changing, we want it to update the period of the thingy. So this is the actual value. So right now it's defaulted on 2 pi. So essentially, and if you remember how we do, how we do stuff in trig, that if I do sine of, I'll just do it right here right quick. I'm going to just do it here. It doesn't matter. But if I do y equals sine of x, and then plot it, it's going to look like that. So I'll go, let's go 0 to pi. That would probably mean 0 to pi. Okay, so I've got myself my little plot here going 0 to 2 pi. Apparently I'm not capable of just basic anything right now, so we're just going to come here, girl. There we go. Okay, so now the next thing that I could do is if I want it to be, so let's just say if I go 2 times pi, so that actually makes it show up more. So essentially the more I multiply this by, the more thingies I get. Does that make sense? The more that I see this happen. But what is important to note is that this does not mean, it's not even really 4 pi, I would just say 4x. So like I say 4. So we see it goes 1, 2, 3, 4. So that doesn't mean that the function has a period of 4 pi. It actually means the opposite, that it has a period of 1/4 pi. So think about this. So this is 1/4 pi is the, whatever you call it, I just forgot, is the period, because every quarter pi, it pops up around, right? Because pi divided by 4 is 0.78. Oh, I'm lying. It's not pi over 4. It's 2 pi over 4. There we go, because it's 2 pi. 2 pi over 4. Because it's every 1.7. Oh, I'm glad I checked that. There we go. Okay, so every 1.57, it starts to repeat. Okay, so if we want the period to be, say, 4 pi, we actually need to do the opposite. Let's see. Do this. X over 4. To do that. Okay, so now what you're seeing is this is a much bigger, way bigger than it seems like it should be. Because I'm only showing 2 pi, so I should see a full half of it, and that's not what I'm seeing. So there's the full half of it. Okay, so basically when I do this, now the period is, how shall I say this? So to get the period of 4 pi, so it's 4 pi, and the way that we get that is 2 times, we'll say 1/1/2. Okay, so the pattern is that you multiply twice this coefficient divided by 2. So in this case, the coefficient is 1/2. Coefficient is 1/2. So it's 2 times, or 2 pi times 1/2. And if we want it to be 4 pi, or sorry, if we do 4x, it's 2 pi times 1/4. I'm just trying to make it consistent. So 2 pi times 1 over that coefficient. All right, so basically, okay, I guess I should have just simplified this and just told you the general form, but I was trying to like recreate it, because you don't just memorize this stuff off the top of your head. So if you have a function times x, that's not the period. So it's basically going to be 2 pi divided by whatever that value is. Okay, and that's going to be the period. I guess I should have not called that the period. So we'll do it this way. So the period, or if you give me t, the 2 pi divided by the period. Okay, got it. Okay, so let's see if we've got this straight. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that little slidery thing, and we are going to adjust it so that we can watch this period change, because what we've just kind of done here is play with it manually, but we want to make that happen here. Okay, So essentially, I'm just going to copy this. There's much more clever ways to do this, but right now we're just learning and playing and having a good old time. And so now instead of sine x, I want to, and I'm going to get this backwards the first time, I'm going to basically take it times the changing value divided by 2 pi, or I'm probably doing this backwards. I'll just check. This will be super easy. So right now it's 2 pi. If I go like this, that is definitely the wrong direction. If I go this, that is definitely the wrong direction as well. So I just flipped these. And that's the nice thing about programming, is you can just move on. So it's going to be times 2 pi divided by the changing value. And then I'm going to run it. So whenever I come over to here, there I have it repeats in 1, 2, 3, 4 pi. Okay, because it goes from top to top in 4 pi. So 1, and then that's it, 4 pi. Here the period should be pi, so if it starts, where's a good spot? We'll start here on the 0. So every pi, it repeats itself. Yes, that's exactly what I want. And ultimately, if the period gets sufficiently small, the period is smaller and smaller and smaller, it looks like this. If the period gets larger and larger and larger, it looks like a straight line. So we just have to remember how trig works. But this is kind of cool because now you can, you know, I am terrible at visualization, which is why I still did it backwards, even though I did it manually and then I came over here. You know, I still have to kind of play with it. So you can kind of come through here and now I can change the period and see, okay, 4 pi period and almost 0. And again, we want to make sure that we had kind of blocked off that since we are dividing by the changing value. Let's see what happens. Let's see if it gets mad at us if we do let it go to 0. So see right now it's got this epsilon in there. So if I put the limit at 0, I think it's going to yell at us, which would be great. We want it to yell at us. Nope. Yeah, see how it just, well, it didn't outwardly yell at us, but it is silently judging us because you can't have a sine function with no period. That doesn't make any sense. So it acts the way we expect, and then EPS just says, I just want it to be a super tiny number, and now it's going to work again. So we can go super, 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 super small, and it's great. Yay! And of course, you know, you can play around and you can change colors of these things or whatever you'd like to do to have a nice time with it. You know, no judgment here. Whatever you like. Flowers. Oh, God. That was terrible. Anyway, you can kind of play around with it. Do stuff. Whatever makes you happy. I'm assuming you can change maybe the colors here, too. Or is it just going to be lame? Doesn't look like you can change that color. But that's... I changed the font color. Ew. Oh, gosh. Okay. So we're going to make lots of bad decisions here, but that's okay. So hopefully you had some fun, and I'll try and put together some more videos so you can play with AppDesigner a little bit more.